This is part 2 of PowerPoint transitions video. In the first part, we saw all the transitions. I gave you a PPT containing all transitions. And now you know when not to use transitions and when to use transitions. And then you'll be able to choose the right one in the right place. This video is about how I created the PPT containing 135 transitions. This is the process of automation I used, which I'll explain in detail. The first step towards doing that is to understand how automation happens. So we have to use Visual Basic for application. Now this is a slide. Currently there is no transition applied. So first I have to find the syntax of how to apply a transition using VBA. So the syntax happens to be whatever is the slide, slideshow transition, entry effect, and then you specify the effects. Now this is a long list. This is called an enumeration, technically speaking. And this is in alphabetical order. Not necessarily in the order in which we see in this menu. But obviously, when you click here, internally, this is happening. So if I want to apply all of them, I need to have a list of all of them. So I went to the documentation and got the list. So these are the effects. This is the technical name for it. This is the actual value. And this is the English description. So I created two slides. I also put a title and I put a dash. This is the default. Because I have to have 169, I have to create those many slides. So I selected both the slides, I copied them. So those two slides are in clipboard now. And I wrote a simple macro which says basically 168 times, paste it. So if you run this macro, see what happens. It quickly created so many slides. But now what do I have to do? I have to go through each slide, actually the even slides, and then apply that particular effect. Now, in order to do that, I need to use this in a loop. How many times? Whatever number of times. So I created an array of 169 things and two columns. Now, what is the syntax of that array? I have to populate that array, right? So first will be the effect enum, which essentially translate to an integer, and then the English name for it. So I got this table in Excel. For that array, I want to create this syntax. So array 1, 2, 3 elements. So I have to have a serial number. Nowadays there is a sequence function. So I use that sequence function to create. Now remember, sequence function cannot be a part of a table. That's why it's outside. I want to create two rows from each row here. Why? Because the array requires first and second element. First element is the effect and second is this. So for this, I created this function. Looks like a complex function, but it's not. It's just a simple concatenation. The name of the array, and then that C4 is the serial number I created, comma 1 first element, whatever is there in the name column, which is the enum, and then character 1310 is CRLF on new line, and then again second the description. When I pasted it in Word, it happened like this. So I just need to get rid of all the quotes. First of all, just search for double quotes and replace with nothing, replace all. And then wherever there is tilde, I want to replace with actual quotes. So now my syntax is ready. I copy pasted it in the code. So if you see this code, we have a slide object, we have a presentation object, shape object, which is actually not being used. This is the place where I defined the array. And then this is the array definition. We are populating the array by copy pasting from Word. Okay, and now I can iterate that array. Whatever the number of U-bound means, total number of elements in the array. And now with the slide, I want even slide. So whatever is the current iteration multiplied by 2, I apply the transition. And I have put on error resume next earlier because some of those transitions are actually not in use. They were probably in use earlier, but they have been replaced with better ones, something like that. So many of them actually generate error, around 12 or 15 of them. This is the set of slides which don't have transitions applied right now. None, none, none. And now when I run this code, see what happens. Now this one has blinds. This one has box right and so on. And that is how I created the PPT. I hope you find this useful, interesting, and maybe you got some ideas and learned something. By the way, creating presentations is one thing. How to present effectively is equally important. I have a great video which is very popular. Have a look at that as well. That's it for now. Thank you.